morning. Thank you for joining us for our morning motivation presented by the FBC ministerial staff.
Good morning. Good morning. It's a beautiful morning. I don't care if there are clouds out, it's still a beautiful morning because God has given us another opportunity to go forth and give Him glory in this day. I personally read about five devotionals that I have each morning. They're not long, but I need something sometimes just to get me going. And I read something today that I really want to share with you. It comes from the devotional entitled Jesus Today, and it's from the author of Jesus Calling. It says, I am taking care of you. Look at that. I know how hard this is to believe when conditions that are troubling you seem to get worse instead of better. It's easy to feel as if I am letting you down, as if I really don't care about what you're going through. You know, I could instantly change your circumstances, and you can't understand why I seem to be so unresponsive to your prayers. But I repeat, I am taking care of you. To become aware of my loving presence, you need to relax and stop trying to control things. Ooh, that speaks to me. Give up your futile efforts to think your way through problems. Fall back into my strong arms with a sigh of trust. Cease striving and simply enjoy being in my presence. Though there are many things you don't understand, you can rest in my unfailing love. This love is independent of all circumstances, and it will never be taken away from you. Although my ways may be mysterious and unfathomable, my love is perfect and everlasting. Watch in hope for me, remembering that I am God, your Savior. What really helped me with this devotion this morning is the very first sentence. And she repeated that in the devotion. It is, I am taking care of you. God said He'd never leave us. He said He would never forsake us. What we have to do is learn how to take it to God and leave it there. Now, that might seem so simple. Take it to the Lord in prayer and leave it there. That was my biggest problem. Not taking it to the Lord, but leaving it there. Because I used to take it. I used to get on my knees. I would go to the altar. I would lay prostrate. And guess what? 10 minutes later, I picked that thing right back up and be trying to figure out how I'm going to resolve this. So I had to come up with a way for me that helped me. So what I did, I took an old, believe it or not, fish locker, like a locker, tackle box, that's what it was called, a tackle box. I labeled it prayer box, and I had a devotional. So what I would do, I had to learn how to sit down and write out all my issues to God. I would write a letter, dear God, put it all down there. Love, Brenda. Like he didn't know it was me. But anyway, I wrote everything out. I wrote out the issue. I wrote out how I felt about it. I would then fold that letter up and take it to the prayer box and close the prayer box. That was my way of taking it to the Lord and leaving it right there. Now, I would also write in my journal that's what I did on that day. I would write it out, not long, but I took it to the Lord and left it there. And then I found that I was not concerned about it. Over time, it took a minute. But the good thing was, God always answered my prayer. Now, I'm not saying He answered it the way I wanted it to be answered, but when He did answer it, it worked for my good. I would then take that letter out the prayer box, because it was answered then. I would take it outside and burn it up, literally burn it up, give thanks to God. Then I would go to my journal, and you know what I would do? The day that I was delivered, the day that he answered my prayer, I would write across that prayer request in my journal in red ink the date. And what that did to me was, whenever I encountered any other kind of situations, at first, the very first thing I would do was go pick up my journal and just flip it, just flip it. And when I began to see all those red marks where God had delivered me, I was like, hey, if he did it then, if he delivered me from that, this is nothing for God. So I'm here to tell you, if we learn how to take it to him and leave it there, because he said, cast our cares upon him because he cares for me, then I'm telling you, you will be much better off, because then we'll realize that God is taking care of you. Be blessed today.
Thank you for joining us for another moment of inspiration. It is our prayer that you have been motivated, encouraged, and inspired by today's word.